Hello children, welcome you all for 9th standard English class. In the previous class, I had started supplementary reading lesson 2, Earthquake. First, we'll have a recap of the lesson already covered. In the previous class, Bridge had met a stranger and took him to his tea shop and offered a tea. After that, he was eager to tell about his village, Molti, to the stranger. The earthquake, which lasted for less than 5 minutes but had destroyed 602 villages out of 670. Open your textbook page number 199, children. I'll be reading from point 12 to 14. It was sheer chance that I was away that night. I had gone to Pauri to buy my school books. I stayed the night at my uncle's house. We felt the tremors. We ran out into the open. Again and again the tremors came. We spent the entire night outside. Pauri lived through the night. Molti did not. For the living, the nightmare began at daybreak when the news trickled in of the large-scale devastation. There were dozens of landslides, huge boulders thrown haphazardly across motorable tracks and roads. Precious time was spent in blasting the rocks and clearing the way for army rescue teams. It was all of 4 days before help arrived for Molti. I was among the first to reach the village. My uncle accompanied me. We feared the worst, but nothing had prepared us for what we saw. Every single house, every wall, every roof had been flattened. Stone, rubble and dust were all that remained. Our house was a two-storied stone building with a slate roof. My great-grandfather had built the house. We were a small family. My father had died after an illness just 14 months ago. My mother took care of us. We were 3 children. I was the oldest. My brother Neelu was 10. Bully, my 2-year-old sister, was the baby of the family. My grandmother lived with us. New words which we have come across in this stanzas are boulders, large rock, haphazard, lacking order. By chance, Bridge had been to Pauri to purchase books and had stayed in his uncle's house. The people of Pauri had felt the tremors and they had stayed out of the house all night. Do you know why they had stayed out of the house, children? Yes, good. It is a precautionary method that when there is a slight feeling of tremor, we have to move out to an open area and not stand near the building or under a tree, but be in an open ground when the earthquake takes place. We will continue the lesson, children. Next morning, there was a news regarding the large-scale devastation. Buildings, mountains had crushed and blocked across the roads. Army rescue teams spent their time in blasting the rocks and clearing the way. It took 4 days for the army officials to reach Molti. Bridge and his uncle had reached before the army. Almost every house, every wall, every roof had flattened. Bridge recollects about his house and his family. His house was a two-storied stone building, which was built by great-grandfather. His father had died 14 months ago due to illness. There were 3 children. Bridge was eldest. His brother Neelu, who was 10 years old, and Bully, 2 years old sister. Mother and grandmother also lived along with them. Reading from point number 15 to 17, children. When the soldiers began to clear the debris, my uncle led me away. I was in a complete daze, too numb to feel anything. The soldiers had set up a makeshift camp. Someone gave me tea and biscuits. I don't know how long I was there. Suddenly, It was evening and uncle was standing beside me. "They have taken the bodies to the river bank," he said gently. "Come, you must perform the last rites before sunset. Tomorrow we'll go back to Pauri." I had not seen my family while living for Pauri. They stood at the doorway and waved. Ma, Dadi, Neelu and Buli. This is the way I will always remember them, smiling and waving at me, not as the white-shrouded, lifeless figures I saw. Buli, she was not there. "They have not found her," my uncle said. "The wild animals. Bridge, don't look like that. She is dead." "But we must find her," I shouted. "Bridge, get a grip on yourself," uncle pleaded. Debris, which means wreckage or all the broken pieces. Soldiers had started clearing the debris. Army also had made a makeshift camp to help the injured. Bridge was made to sit in one place and someone had given him tea and biscuits. Evening, all the dead bodies were dumped near the riverbank and were calling Bridge to perform the last rites. Bridge was feeling uncomfortable to look at the dead bodies as he had a good old memories of his family, smiling and waving at Bridge before going to Pauri. When Bridge had realized that his sister's body was not found, uncle tries to console him by saying that wild animals might have eaten up, but Bridge was not ready to listen to him at all. I'll continue from point 18 to 22, children. But I was beyond reasoning. I ran back to the village to the spot where my house had stood. There was still so much of debris. I scrambled around shifting the earth and stones. How long I was on my knees searching, crying, searching. "Boy, it's no use," a voice said. I looked up. The speaker was the army officer who had supervised the relief operation. "There is no one alive in there," he said. "Whom are you looking for?" "My sister, Sahib," I said, fighting to control my tears. "All I want is to give her a proper cremation." I stopped, conscious that I was babbling. I could see that he was bone tired. He looked as if he had not slept for days. His uniform was covered with the dust. His face was grimy, but through all the dust and grim, I saw that his eyes were kind. The word which we have come across here is babbling, which means repeat. A phrase which we have come across here is bone tired, which means completely exhausted. As Bridge was beyond reasoning, he ran to the place where his house was situated and started searching on his knees, crying and trying to find his sister. After a long time, Bridge turned towards the voice. It was none other than the army officer who was trying to convince Bridge that his searching was of no use. No one was alive. But Bridge, in a stubborn way, says the army officer that he wants a sister at least to give a proper cremation. Bridge noticed the face of an army officer who was completely tired and had not slept for days together. His uniform was covered with the dust, but even then, his eyes were filled with the kindness. Assignment of the day. First one, where was Bridge when the earthquake took place? Second, how long did it take for the army officials to reach Molti? I'll continue the last part of the lesson in the next class, children. Thank you.